57. But yeah, you know, people forget about it. What's the day after?
Is that Boxing Day the 26th, by the
way? I think it is.
Could have been your nickname.
There you go.
That's where we start our summer league action.
He can take you off the dribble. He can guard 3, 4, 5 with that big, strong body. So they're really looking for him to take a leap.
Let's it fly on a three, absorb some contact, but still able to knock down the triple for Brown. Jordan Miller, I should say, is we got back-to-back three-pointers by Kobe Brown.
Very simple with what he does with the basketball to get 36 points. Gilliard now with the second turnover, took it into a couple bad spots.
Oh, Miller had such difficulty with bodies down low, able to control his body, slow the speed, and get it in. Johnson, pretty good on that fade, looking like that game winner the other night.
That's obviously a shot he really likes. To take you to one spot or a full pivot, he likes to shoot the fadeaway, finding that rim as he comes out of the spin.
Diakite glides in and scores. Diabate, I should say. Diabate. Well, Keon Johnson is not the first time he's playing for Steve Hetzel, who is the summer league coach for the Nets. As a three-pointer goes down for Jalen Wilson, who couldn't miss. Ball tipped, and the Clippers come away with it with some numbers. Miller hit hard and scored anyway.
Yeah, it's amazing. The natural scorers find a way. Ray J. Dennis, by the way, took that last three, just checked into the game. I'm really interested in watching him play today as well, because he's one of the best I think we have in Vegas. Run some ball screen and make guys better by giving kickouts.
Keon Johnson with that bucket for Brooklyn, just their third field goal, and they're right on cue, Ray J. Dennis. Martin on the drive, and outside it goes to Johnson. Gets the roll, but that kind of starts the summer league for Keon Johnson. Very well-traveled Keon Johnson so far. Diabate tried to thread the needle on that pass. Fortunate to get another opportunity and cashed in by Terry Taylor.
Clippers with four threes in the first 6.5 minutes of this game.
Shooting 70% from the field so far. Johnson trying to find some space, missed, got the offensive rebound, and puts it in. Keon Johnson has 9 of Brooklyn's last 12 points until right there where Jalen Martin scored, just signed a two-way contract recently. Must have been and still is for you among all the great accomplishments you've had.
One of my best memories of that weekend was as I go into the finals of the three-point shootout was Juwan Howard asking Reggie Miller for his money, because I guess he bet and laid some money on me. That was a good feeling.
He got a lot of praise from Dante Jones on his ability to spark things when he comes into the game.
Yeah, I mean, he really made a point to make sure we watch him. He said he's changed every practice.
Felt pretty good.
Look at Steve Hetzel going a little 1-2-2 full court trap after those free throws.
And a foul on a three out of the corner. And the voice of Sean Marks, general manager of the Brooklyn Nets, watching Jalen Wilson defending right here. Wilson was so terrific in the fourth quarter. There may be, Kevin Durant size 14 or size 16 sneaker away from maybe beating Milwaukee in the second round the year the Bucks win the championship. And now one just playoff series win in that Kevin Durant, Kyrie Irving run into this new iteration of basketball. And a shot blocked by Noah Clowney. Brooklyn has missed 17 of their last 18 shots. They've also missed their last 9 three-point attempts.
31-18 in the first quarter, 6-3 in this quarter.
Ray J. Dennis, who was the number 38 pick. All right, maybe the offense will start picking up now.
I'm sure. Did you ever spend any time in the L.A. Sports Arena?
Oh,
back in the day?
I've never been in there, but have seen video.
And now you go from that to this. Can't wait to see it.
Where the cup holder is, there is a USB-C connection, so you will be able to power up all your
devices. Right. There you go.
Yes, for the Clippers.
Continue to just rain threes. They're 9 for 16 here. Still a minute 40 to go in the first half.
And 7 in the first quarter, and here we go.
And then steps out on the other end and knocks down a three. That's the modern day big that teams are looking for. Rim protection and then spacing on the other end. And then here he is on the offensive glass. That's a great, I'm guessing he probably gave him a couple of those
over the years
growing up.
You know, when Cam walked into the building, I was like, what's Max Christie doing here? You know those guys are brothers. They have shot clock winding down to 5. Gilliard had it stripped away, gets it, a tough, tough angle, and he hits. How about that for a degree of difficulty?
Well, that'll get you back in it.
You'll take it in the box score, right? Cam Christie answering with a three of his own.
Yeah, they really like his ability. He only had one hand free because Trevor Hudges had a grip on the other arm.
We talk about 10 fouls to foul out, 10 team fouls as well to get into the bonus. A little speed there from Jacob Gilliard.
His body just breaking down, and so they were left shorthanded out there and were not able to.
Came on late in the season, and the future looks so promising for him and Jason Kidd's club down in Big D.
Yeah, the two-headed monster in the middle. Mike Budenholzer coming in there to see what kind of an impact he can have on a very talented roster. The West is no joke, Justin.
No, it is not. And then the Houston Rockets on Friday night. We'll get a look on ESPN2 coming up a little bit later on today here at Thomas and Mack. And a basket for the Clippers and for Amari Bailey on the wraparound.
Well, he's probably going to find a way to get a bucket. I mean, you talk about point per minute. He's just electrifying and really took the league by storm a little bit a year ago when he went on a huge scoring barrage that lasted about a month. Where he felt like he was getting 30 or 40 every single night as well for them, obviously, with the way he can light it up. So he's going to be a major focal point for them going forward. We talked to Sean Marks about, you know, Ben Simmons, and I know that's a big if because he just has missed so much time over 3 years. But
it's almost hard to remember now, the Ben Simmons who won the Rookie of the Year after sitting out a year at two and a half really productive seasons in Philly. And now Derek Whitehead really nice starting team. To heat up. He came back to beat the Indiana Pacers. Can they do it again? We'll find out.
Well, it's going to start here, and this is the only way you're able to do it. String together stops. I certainly don't want to give up an uncontested layup. Miscommunication there on the ball screen defense.
And the game winner on Friday in overtime. Great feed, better block. Christie, oh, and a foul called. Noah Clowney went up. That looked clean from our angle. Shot clock at 10. Whitehead at the three-point line. Break knocks it in.
Nice step back three right there. Whitehead, he's got a lot in his game in beating guys off the dribble, but that time got to his step back game. And here's Jordan Miller again. And again, the deceleration.
Got to the line nine times, made them all. Bannon on the ball fake against Clowney, a really tough shot to score.
Very difficult.
Bannon, the Aussie from Melbourne. Medium range J for Keon Johnson going down. I'll remind everyone, I know they came back down 15. They were down 14 with 4:20 to go on Friday. Inside, Clowney drops it through. Drive Johnson, who had the game winner the other day, rejected. Kobe Brown on a beautiful feed from Jordan Miller.
Nice job by Miller that time. He wanted to get to the rim of the open floor, but a good job. The Nets getting back and cutting him off, but didn't pull it back out. Picked it up and saw Kobe Brown running the floor.
Johnson hitting a three with 4:20 to go in the ball game. 3 seconds to shoot for Keon Johnson. Hit it! Right over the outstretched arm of Cam Christie.
Just about the Clippers. That was multiple on-ball defensive efforts on that possession. Three different guys, but Keon Johnson has the answer at the end of the day.
Clippers just too tough on the offensive end. Inside was his assistant back then, but he said that's the thing with Keon. He's starting to see the reads before they even happen as Jalen Wilson drops that triple there. Here on a Sunday afternoon, 13 of them coming from the line.
Something tells me these scorers, you know, they're not done. He's going to get a couple more free throws here before this thing ends.
Probably right. Like used to conference. Know the WAC and the
every
Mountain West
conference.
Out here.
Yeah, the MAC conference, the A-10, every all of them. Good luck with that now.
Johnson gets two more points. Yeah, don't quiz me now. I have no chance.
And ends up with 27 points with that three with a scoring burst here in the fourth quarter.
Final score.